Peace and blessings, and welcome back to Bodybuilding for Brass Players. I'm Umbikalian today. What it is it's Monday morning, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to just share with you my workout and my warm-up. So there's music in the background. I've got Pandora playing. Yeah, I still use Pandora anyway, and it's the free version, so you can hear some ads. I am not trying to infringe on copyright or intellectual property or anything. The reality is this is how I work out in the mornings, and I'm just sharing that with you 100% honest. So please do not, you know, I'm just saying it now. I don't own the rights to any of this music. I don't claim to or anything, but I'm just going to share with you this morning, like I said, my morning workout routine, as well as how I warm up. So what I've been doing is working out, lifting weights, getting the body going, and also getting on the horns every morning. And so I'm going to share with you how I do that. Okay, basic process, it's Monday. So what I normally do on Mondays is do something with shoulders. So I'm going to do some shoulder dumbbell flies to get things warmed up and working this morning. Probably going to go kind of heavy on those, and then after that I'm going to go to the shoulder, just a standing overhead press with the shoulders. What I'm going to do when I go to the shoulder press is I'm also going to take the weight way down and warm up. Normally I would start with the barbell with the overhead shoulder press, but I'm not going to do that this morning because I want to make sure I get some good time on the flies. All right, so that all being said, just stay with me on this journey and this workout and have some fun with me. Yeah. All right, we're gonna start off just with some real light weights. I'm gonna grab a couple of 2.5 pound plates. That's it. I'm gonna warm up with those. Then I'm gonna take a resistance band and just go right from there into some heavier and heavier weights. All right, let's go. What I do with these, maybe you can see this from the back, I don't know, is I try to do this from multiple angles when I'm doing my shoulder flies. Okay, I go back a little bit with it, I go forward a little bit with it, and just do different angles. Try to show you different angles on that. Water.
Where's my water?
Ah, there it is. So, it seems like a lot of the cats I look at on YouTube and that I follow all have their own pre-workout supplements and everything. And you see them at the beginning of every video taking this supplement, this pre-workout and everything. And that's cool, you know, whatever. I'm not endorsing a pre-workout. The only thing I do as a pre-workout is I have a soup spoonful of peanut butter, an antihistamine, and a caffeine pill. You're not gonna see me take those, but I'll take those, you know, in this video. But I also drink water a bit during my workout. And I may have like cucumber water or cucumber and mixed berry water or something. But that's it. That works for me, you know. So the next thing during the workout is I'll have my music going on, and then I'll pick up a horn, and I'll warm up. And with this, I'm figuring out first off, what key is the song in? And then from there, I'm just improvising with it, okay? Focusing on intonation, focusing on articulation, sorry. Really trying to get my articulations going first thing in the morning, getting good airflow, you know, and all those things you look for in a good sound. One of the reasons why I go between lifting weights and playing the horn is because, you know, once you're getting really into the workout and your cardiovascular system is really kicking in, to go between working out, like lifting weights and then playing a horn is quite a challenge. And so if you can do that really well, you're really going to focus on breath support, you're going to focus on efficiency and stamina, because you have to. Like, you can't play long tones after doing a good set if you don't really focus on what you're doing. So just to give you an example, I'm gonna figure out what key this is in. It's probably most times it's a minor key in hip hop, and then go from there. So F minor. I can't hear it. Hold on a second. I'm in wrong key. That's a minor key. Specific music, or saying you should listen to this or shouldn't listen to that, and I'm sorry there's profanity in the, I'm not sorry, it's artistic, it's music, you know, it is what it is, it's hip hop. But my point is that, if you can hear, you know, I'm not trying to say to promote any music, like I said, I don't own any rights to any of this, I just put on Pandora in the morning, and I just go to work. So one of the things I was going to say real quick, and I'm just going to get right into the workout and get deep into it, is that I don't know of many people who are sharing videos of them practicing, really. I'm not saying they should or shouldn't, but that's what I'm doing right now. I'm just sharing with you. It's first thing in the morning. Right now, it's about 5:50 in the morning. I got to get deep into these weights and everything, get it in. And I'm sharing with you my actual practice. Not a practice routine, not a strategy, but I'm sharing with you actually my strategy and an example of me doing it. So if you hear some fuzziness or whatever, it's truly first thing in the morning. That all being said, let's get into it. I'm tired of talking. Let's get into this. So I'm going to keep going with these flies. I'm going to go from 10 pounds, then I'm going to go to about 15 to 20 pounds and take them up and up and up, and I'm going to be playing in between each set. Let's go. I'm going to show you multiple angles.
Thank you.
I should get my biceps and triceps warmed up too. Those are 20s. Now these are about 25. Got two 10-pound plates plus the handle or the bar, whatever you want to call it. So that's about 25 pounds. Same thing. Warming them up. And this is beyond the warm-up at this point. And so really, rep range really depends on what your goals are. And my goals right now are, in general, my goal is to put on more muscle mass. And with that being said, I'm going for heavier and heavier weights. Also, not just putting more muscle mass, but also just, increasing my maximum weights with every different lift. So that being said, I might not do as many reps, but just focus on heavier and heavier weights, getting more and more sets in with the heavier and heavier weight. So hold on a second. Okay. I just missed the whole song. Focus on more weight right now, not as many reps. Woo! Shoulder flies, the dumbbell flies, but doing those flies with 45 pounds, that's a workout. Second that I'm as good on tuba as I'm on trombone, and I'm going to pick up the trumpet in this video. But what I enjoy doing is I enjoy being a multi-instrumentalist. And truth be told, if somebody asked me to do a brass band gig, or something like that, or quartet gig, or brass quintet or whatever, I would be okay with a tuba. Getting my chops really focused on that, really getting in shape, I'd be fine on that. But especially my improv chops are not on tuba what they are on trombone. That all being said, what I'm doing, like I said, is I'm showing you my actual practice. I'm not showing you some polished thing. The reality is it's first thing in the morning. You know, I still have to get ready, you know, all that wonderful stuff, and I'm showing you the reality. So hopefully that's helpful and encouraging. You know, it's okay to sound like a beginner when you're practicing, or like you're learning something new when you're practicing, because that's what you should be doing. So let me get one more set here, and then go ahead and switch over. Different angle this time. Right into some lunges or some squats or whatever from there. I'm gonna still work on these shoulders this morning. All right, so what am I laughing at? Well, it's fun working out. Anyway, the point is that like I said, we're about to get in these shoulder press, this shoulder overhead press. If there's a different name for this, I do apologize. I've heard it called the strict press and some other things. Point is, I'm taking this barbell and putting it over my head. So when I'm doing this, yeah, I am focusing on form. I'm going to go behind the head when I do this, a little bit. My arms will be back here a little bit as I press this out. Pardon my belly if it's showing a little bit. I apologize. I'm a pretty modest individual, you know, I like to show a lot of skin. That all being said, let's go ahead. Just starting with the bar. This right here is on here for when I deadlift, because you deadlift. I like to do it a lot of times with shorts on, and that's a dumb idea. When you think about it, this is going to scrape your legs right up. So if this is on here to protect my legs, my deadlift, I figured I'm going to just leave it on there. So I don't really wrap my knees up with both of these at once long anyway. So that being said, here we go. You can't see it. Hold on. Let me adjust that camera. And for what it's worth, real quick, those jackets and their blazers or whatever are actually pings. So we're like, why in the world do you have pros in the basement? And because those are things. We'll get to that later. Maybe. All right, let's go. Let's go a little wider. Now, normally when I'm doing these, I'm actually facing the weight rack, okay? I'm facing this way for you guys. I don't feel like setting the whole gym back up in order for you to be able to see this, would be facing the rack. So, just for what it's worth, I like to dismount, put the weights back down, re-rack them in front of me versus going back, but that's okay. So anyway, let's go. Mm-hmm. Improvising, figuring out what key that's in. Improvising based on that key, focusing on articulation, focusing on creating melodic ideas, something that sounds good. Also focusing on exercise, octaves, intervals, scales, whatever. Anything you would normally work on in your warm-up routine, you can do long tones in this. But the thing about it is you got some music in the background. Old school cats talk about playing with the radio when they were growing up. It's no different from playing with the radio. Turn the radio on and just practicing with the radio. Same concept as what I'm doing right here. All right? Only with Pandora. Not endorsing Pandora, but just saying. That's what I'm using. Hold on. Clip's wrong there, right? Yeah. Honestly, those shoulder flies earlier, the dumbbell flies, whatever, took a bit out of me. Like that last set with the 45s, it's a lot of work. It's a lot of work. So it's like a certain point when your body says, okay, that's it. But I'm not listening to that right now. So I'm really making sure that I take my time, that I don't overdo it, because I don't want to pass out with something with the weights. Versus doing a normal warm-up, like not normal warm-up, but versus doing something that's written down, or even some of the exercises that I'm working on putting in this book. The improvising, it's breaking up all these different decision-making parts of the brain, you know, and you know, with the tuba, I don't have the muscle memory on tuba that I have on the trombone, where things kick in a whole lot better. So there's a whole lot more brain power that I have to use to sound good on the tuba. And you can hear me flubbing around and messing up these ideas, and messing up notes. And I think that's actually a good thing, because that I'm sharing that with you, because I am utilizing a part of my brain, I'm exercising a part of my brain that's weaker on tuba than it is on trombone. Whatever that is, I don't know how all the brain works. But my point is, though, it's like I'm real strong on this instrument. I pick up this one, and I'm good, but I'm not great. So what's that doing? It's making me even greater, even stronger in the things that I'm weaker at. And guess what? That's going to translate right over into my facility on the trombone when I get to the trombone, or on the trumpet if for some reason I want to play on the trumpet and do the same thing. So it's and also for the embouchure. You know, going between mouthpieces is also a crazy thing for the embouchure. It's shocking the muscles, it's shocking the mind, it's shocking the body. So that all being said, let's get into this next set. I'm gonna take the weight up, but I'm also gonna put my belt on. Like I said, I'm gonna use this belt to get into this next set. With this set, I'm focusing on, honestly, I don't even know, because I'm already kind of worn out from that last exercise. So we'll see. All right. Got my clips on both sides, right? Okay. Bad at all, actually. Hold on a second. Yeah, it was actually pretty good. It felt great. About 6 reps. Could have gone to 8 or more, but I want to go heavier, so. Huh, wasn't bad. Talking in this video, but I'm gonna go ahead and talk for a second. So one of the things I really want to do in this YouTube series, in this video series, because it might not be stuck on YouTube at some point, but in this video series, one of the things I want to do is really get into serious weightlifting. You know, with bodybuilding for brass players, I am not for even a second pretending to be a professional bodybuilder, okay, at all. I mean, I don't even have the body composition for that. I got too much body fat on me to go out and compete. And I'm okay with that. I'm not interested in losing body fat to go and competing on stage. But what I am doing, though, is seriously getting into strength training and trying to get as strong as I can get. focus on a lot of strength. So maybe it's more powerlifting than bodybuilding, but getting into also the discipline of bodybuilding in terms of how that relates to practice. So what I'm trying to say in a roundabout way is that I don't want you to look at this series and say, oh, he's always got weights in the background, or he's talking about the weights, but he's not actually showing us in lifting weights. Like, I'm really lifting weights. Right now, I'm about 225 on average, and the average morning average morning weigh-in. Right now, I'm a little bit lower than that. I'm about 222, I think, 223, pounds-wise. And point is, you know, I'm a professional musician. I'm a teacher. I'm a, you know, all this stuff. I'm a creative person, but I do get on the weight seriously, and I'm working on getting you know, stronger and stronger and stronger. I'm not where I want to be, and that's okay. But I just want you to know that I'm taking this very seriously. So when I'm talking about bodybuilding for brass players, I want to show you that I'm actually getting it in the gym. So that all being said, let's go on this set. Same thing. I don't know how many reps I'm going for. As long as I get a couple, I'm happy. Anyway, that being said, let's get this set. Plan at all. I'm tired. My body is worn out. I was like, come on. Nah, hold on, man. Let me sit down. This whole time I have not sat down. And I can feel it up here. When you know you've worked out, well, you can feel it up here. You know, there's this, for me, and I'm sure I'm not the only person, there's this point where you know, I'm sure it's in the nervous system where you can feel it in your brain, in your head, where you say something has flipped, where you know, okay, I'm about done. So, might be done. Because that fatigue is strong right there. So, I got one. What is this? 155. I got one rep. Whew. I hate to leave it there, though, man. I hate to leave it there. Let's see if I can clear my mind, right? Get some energy and get a couple reps. That was sad. Let's try one more time. This thing, I'll pick the horns up again in a second. Let me try at least get a couple reps on that, man. I know I can lift that weight. All right, here we go. There we go. Woo! Mind over matter, baby. All right. Whew, and watch me pass right out right. Oh, I'm done. No. All right. Woo! All right, cool. Whoo, man. All right, so thank you for watching this video. You know, it's kind of a long video, but I'm trying to share with you all, you know, the workouts that I'm doing, because while I'm talking about on this series, while I'm interviewing people who are sharing their experience, their philosophies, their pedagogical approaches to things, while I'm talking about what I'm working on, what I believe is going to help you to build tone quality and all this stuff like that, I'm also really getting into these weights and into this gym, and this is real, you know. So I want to share with you what I'm really doing. Now, the reality is this, just to talk about the fatigue aspect for a second. You know, I'm not a nutritional expert or anything, but I can tell you from my own experience, this entire series is about sharing my experience with you all. Your morning fatigue has a whole lot to do with your last night of eating, what you ate the day before, as well as probably days before maybe, but definitely the night before. So last night, I didn't really eat much. Yesterday was Sunday night, and really, I had a great breakfast, and then I wasn't really hungry later in the day. I had some chicken. I fried up some chicken and fried some shrimp. I just had a little bit here and there to eat, and then later on, I ate some cooked kale, and that was it. And I really wasn't hungry yesterday. And I know today, my lack of energy, that early onset, because it's kind of early, you know, onset fatigue, the way it hit me, the way it did, is because my body doesn't have anything to work off of. You know, when you're working out on a basically empty stomach, like I have that peanut butter in the mornings, but I'm not really doing a whole lot of, I'm not eating anything like a meal before then. And all you've really got is that little bit of energy that you just consumed, plus whatever you got in reserves. And normally I would be drinking, my water might be infused with, like I said, cucumbers or berries or beet juice. I like to have beet juice. I just haven't bought any recently yet, so I haven't in the fridge right now. And that gives you some power and some energy to keep going. But right now all I've got is my reserves. And so, you know, once you when you're really into it, you only got a little bit to work out, to work with, and the body's going to say, okay, I need to stop. And so those last two reps right there were really just me telling myself I'm physically able to lift that weight and showing you all, for whatever it's worth, that I'm able to lift, what was that, 160? I think, yeah, it wasn't 160. It was 165. Yeah, it was 165. You know, just to show that I could do two reps. But honestly, you know, I'm fatigued and I know that. So really that has a lot to do with what I ate yesterday and not really eating right yesterday, even though, but I seriously was like, my body was like, don't eat any. So I had to listen to my body in both days. That all being said, I hope this video is helpful. You know, the whole thing about it is this going back and forth between the physical training and the practicing, but not separating the two any more than we have to. So, you know, a lot of people compartmentalize their practice and their work on their horns and their physical work. What I mean by that is a lot of times, you know, in marching band is a good example. In marching band camp, when you're doing conditioning and stuff, you're running, you're doing the calisthenics, you're doing all that wonderful stuff that you need to do to be in shape. And then you pick up the horn later on, you know, you do that for an hour or a half hour in the mornings, and then you go and pick up the horn later on in the afternoon or later on in the morning or whatever. This is putting the two together in a healthy, safe way. You don't want to do like some crazy stuff, like something we were doing in high school was doing crunches or a half sit-up and then playing scales. That stuff is just destroying your body, and you can get hernias doing it like I did. But it's really about going back and forth between real, serious strength training and practicing, immediately into the practicing. And what you're going to do is you're going to shock your body in so many different ways. And you're going to shock your mind, and you're going to grow in so many ways. And what you'll learn, you know, so my interview with Dr. Joseph Lee Jefferson, a good brother of mine, he was talking about breaking down your practice routine into different 20-minute segments throughout the day. And when you're, you know, lifting weights and then, or doing push-ups, whatever, and then picking up the horn, you're not getting a solid hour on either one. You might only get a half hour of each, but guess what? They're feeding off of each other. Anyway, look at this for a second. I'm going to wrap this up soon, but look at this for a second. When my body's already exhausted, I'm pumping and pumping, and then the pulmonary system, you know, my breathing, I'm in overdrive, right? And then I pick up my horn, where I'm not putting out nearly as much air, but I am consuming a lot of air. Like the air efficiency changes, the air flow changes, and then I go back to the weights. You know, I may not, you know, and you can see I wasn't able to lift as much as I'm able to lift, but guess what? I'm shocking my body, which is going to it's going to stimulate growth in the body. It's going to cause my body to say, okay, I need to be stronger in this way and in that way. You know, so the point is, keep it safe. First off, keep it safe. Don't do anything that you're not safe doing, you're not comfortable doing. Challenge yourself, but do it safely. But also, you know, going back and forth between the two. You know, I'm not a big fan of or proponent of breathing exercises. Why am I, and this is just my philosophy, this is just me talking, you can do what you want to do. Hold on 1 second. Okay, one of my microphones was pointing totally the wrong way. It's still a little off, but whatever. I'm not a big fan of breathing exercises. I'm not. Maybe just a couple of nice full breaths to get, you know, to get life going.
But after that, do something. Do some squats. Do a couple push-ups. Do lunges or some, you know, if you want to do crunches or something, do a plank. Do some long tones. You know, if you want your air to support, if you want to have more air support and breath support in your sound, then play. I'm sorry, that's just me. I don't want to compartmentalize all these different things and hope that my sound gets better, because it might improve short term. But long term, I'm talking about more than just a practice session or a performance. Long term, this type of stuff is showing me what I can do with my body just using the air that I'm going to be flowing with. I hope that all makes sense. You know, put it all together. Put it together. Don't necessarily separate. I mean, let me breathe over here, then let me do this over here, then let me pick up a horn. Put it all together in a way that works for you, that challenges your body, challenges your mind, and forces you to grow. Force your body to grow and to change and to develop into who you want to be. That's my philosophy. That all being said, I hope this video was interesting, maybe exciting, I don't know, inspiring. You know, like I said, I'm not an IFBB bodybuilder. I'm a musician, I'm a dad. You know, a lot of bodybuilders are dads, but I'm saying I'm a dad, you know, I'm a teacher, I'm doing, you know, this is what I do. So hopefully it's also inspiring, so you can see someone maybe in the same kind of boat as you are doing this also for real. So please like the video, subscribe to the channel, and please share this. Please get other people to check this out. You know, if there's something that you're getting out of this video, don't hog that for yourself. And please share with somebody else. Real quick, I know I'm talking a lot. If you're still with me on this video, then listen to what I'm saying. What I'm telling you today, that this going back and forth between working out and playing a brass instrument, if you're a visual artist, you can do the same thing. There's nothing stopping you besides how you set your space up and your time. If you're a visual artist, if you're an engineer, you're a creative person, you got your treadmill and your computer going, it's the same thing. It's the same thing. The point is, real quick here, sorry that I'm going on and on, this isn't just for brass musicians. This is for any creative person. Whatever you do, whatever your discipline is, you're writing your paper, you're working on your doctorate, and you're going back and forth between lifting and doing this stuff, this can work for you. Put it all together, because it's going to enlighten your mind. It's going to get that blood flowing. It's going to make you feel great, and you can get the work done. All right, that all being said, once again, please like the video, subscribe to the channel, share it with your friends. And until next time, thank you for checking out Bodybuilding for Brass Players. Peace.